Clough's light theory never needs to dispense with high theory. It merely takes up a different relation to it. Things do not have inherently determinate boundaries or properties, and words do not have inherently determinate meanings. Consider the intertextually ignored lines of articulation, sapphiric vapour, wet fade ups, retrieval gaps, transmitter assemblages, or fortune undoings. Consider occurrences of electrical discharge, the possibilities of premonition and prediction, all phenomena that flicker, untimely otherings and uncouplings. Because he's speaking about this very border between knowing and not knowing. Forget probability. Blue was used because it was the farthest away from skin tones, and blue film stock had the smallest grain. Green was easier and cheaper to light than blue. Green registers brighter on electronic displays, worked well for outdoor keys, where the blue screen might match the sky, and the bold green colour was less common in costumes and blueies. In every temporal process, a dark precursor, a vague apparatus or green screen. Response is desire. Desire is response. Reading is theft without the keys. Erotic hot wiring to keep at bay any fantasy of autonomy. Use technology for transgression. Example one, Diagra in flower.
The dodecahedron, 12 pentagonal faces. That looks like a galaxy. The background radiation from when the universe was first created has arranged itself into this odd geometric pattern. Time markings. The alignment of these winged disks. A self-referential diagram. The secret to understanding this mystery that we're dealing with. Vibration. They're vibrating puddle of liquid. The next step. Frog's field chromosome formation. The chromosomes all broken up. There's about to be a cell metamorphosis, double helix. And there's 12 stations, a triple helix, and then boom, what's this? The ladder of the helixes. This is the frozen vibration. Here's your great red spot, which is at the limb of the tetrahedron, and this also extends through the great dark spot. Ordinary particles of sand in it are then vibrated like the white keys on the piano. Atoms and molecules as we know them, not little bitty chunks of matter. They're not behaving the way they should. This is what a wave does. It ripples like two waves on a pond coming together. That's where it can move around in space. In the inverted world, this would all be just kind of an interesting intellectual study until you start looking at large objects. Have you ever had one of those little balloons where you squeeze it in your hand and it goes whoosh? Now just chew on that for a second. If DNA can turn into a wave, then that opens the door to all these quantum non-locality principles. A virus can turn into a wave. more power than any wave that could ever be beamed at you. Energetic beamings. What's over there on the other side when you flip over a card? The three-dimensional realm where time is spaced out. But then you got this whole place on the bottom. Where is that? How do we get there? You got to punch a hole through the apple or the donut in this case as you go down. This whole system can invert.
Weak secretions from the dripping boobo. This work wipes the world clean of brain sound. It's an experiment in collaborative method as pure diagramming. Assembled materials are used according to processes that remain non-communicating, invaginating, interference patterns in meaning-making and collective myths for release into the social bloodstream. The work is an ingrowth from the surface of display, depositing unclean tensions and desires in the cavities of the body politic. Sample 2, Blurgut. Nancy Nervous. Alphaville is a 1965 black and white dystopian sci-fi film while set in Paris, rethinking love and poetry in outlined. One of Alpha 60's dictates is that people should not ask why, but only say because. Does Nancy know this? Example 3. Because he is speaking about this very border between knowing and not knowing, to all appearances feigned, in every temporal process a dark precursor, blue screen or vague apparatus. Special effects are superseded by physical wind, having reverse charisma, real-time searching sense-making. On the face of it, non-typical ruptures in the present, strange non-human histories, monkey ant, pure considered sky, snake, bird arrangements. There is no word after zigzag. The visible divisions ruptures the illusion that the screen's frame is a seamless view of reality, similar to that of the human eye. There may or may not be an explicit borderline. Gestures invite other gestures. Read it fast. Things or pieces of things avoid boundary settings, overlap. Think of it this way. Composition, autonomous subdivisions, parts of subdivisions, anywhere subdivisions. Emergent indeterminate properties pervade both sound and image. We cannot know whether we are inside or outside through use of blue screen and blue screen effect. Read it fast. Articulations stutter between different intensities. Intensities that include oversaturation of colour, shimmering substances, non-diegetic sound, and transdisciplinary couplings that resonant rubbing up with the non-human. The cat breaks the fruit bowl. The pupas spend their time hoping to glue it back together. Consider domestic wind chimes, an ensemble of time relations, coexistent durations and rhythms, usually made of bronze. Roman wind chimes were hung in gardens, courtyards, and porticos where wind movement caused them to tingle. Bells were believed to ward off malevolent spirits and were often combined with the rabbit's phallus, which was also a symbol of good fortune and charm against the evil eye, the very possibility of thinking. The best of diverse can be found on the internet for sure. The dark precursor is made ready for. Reverse path tracings, dissonance, discordance, and difference, brought into close proximity without the use of a video camera or recording device, like the surface of a body of water spreading towards available spaces or trickling downwards towards new spaces through fissures and gaps, eroding what's in its way. Read deep browser doings and goings on, liquid supposition. The very possibility of thinking.
It's not theory-driven. Maybe the questions
are... Well, I don't know what theory-driven was, personally.
It reflects the question we all have, I think. How do we speak in space like this? There's clearly a lot of theory and concepts around which are attractive but not necessarily explaining work, for example, writing work. So this, as a layer, as I think was mentioned this morning anyway, that there's something happening even in half or this or special understandings, and I'm curious about the kind of productivity happens in that space where we need the author of the author text. And I think what you pointed out is that they're saying mise-en-scène happening, particular rhetorics of using images also in the yes, not only, but also in this space. And I think that is very interesting that at one point I might think, oh, I've heard that word before, it's coming from somewhere when he's saying,
phrases before, it's like, I'm afraid I'm not really a particularly myself well, I'm afraid, but I'm curious because I mentioned that this morning, that no, this is not a theory, this is my work, you know, at the same time it's, it feels very much as if it is picking up a lot of quotations, which it does, because you're dealing with so many different images and different kinds of things.
Well, there's definitely some image of lots of ideas. Moving them around, for sure. Image, writing.
Or maybe different, because sometimes as an artist or top people, there's almost a weird necessity of having theory behind the practice. Can't you just do away with that? Which maybe that's a good thing, maybe not, because in some works it does work quite well, that sort of interconnection of theory and practice. And in others, I feel like it's absolutely not necessary. So maybe someone can help me at this, because
that artists not necessarily have to think in that way, but researchers do this. But of course, when we are artists researchers, we can commit both workers as a whole.
There's also
because you see the picture work the voiceover. Yeah. Somehow like we are confused between TV and voiceover and then the mobile image. So maybe my question is relationship. I hope if you have some thoughts around using the image and then the voiceover, what's their relationship and are you the same all three? Or just enter
the stuff happening at the same time, because there's also subtitles as well. So it's just a sort of again, sort of moving lots of different ideas around, or maybe just bringing ideas into the same space at the same time. So not trying to articulate work or justify through theoretical discourse. It's just more ideas as to move around, just sort of invite into the room at the same time and see what happens. If that makes sense.
Yeah. This is maybe my reading of what you've presented. I would have been slightly more stronger, I think, because clearly iconography, so for some of these developing shapes, some clouds, for example, and also the way the speech frame kind of works across those. So I mean, there are certain patterns that develop within their own parameters. And I would have said that between the materials on screen, the material off screen actually, there was a pattern of development that was quite comparable to the world. So if you look at the microscopic, which is a little corner of a mushroom type cloud, you think about it, and at what point that corner may actually form into a concept that you mentioned. So if it's a material, it would be an element that's being mobilized. In some process that binds it together, but it's not just I understand. I've seen things coming together that actually it's some form of development has a pattern of sorts, and that pattern is difficult to put a finger on. I see that the pattern is theory, but nevertheless, it seems to be coherent.
And that
also
so it's on repeat. So it's within an installed situation rather than screen, if that makes sense. So you don't sit down at the beginning and watch and find the screen again as a broken character, which is often to do with comfort or interest or disinterest. How long you spend with any kind of work.
Since you're you interacted with the video. I was wondering whether you perceive your work having started a process in an ending point, or is it real?
But stuff takes care of itself. I like the idea of something taking care of itself. So, the videos on YouTube, they're difficult to find. So they feel kind of complete. But then they might have a life of the next context. There tends to be a companion text to the work, but that's evolving and changing. So they don't settle, if that makes sense. But they are sort of finished.
Okay.
For now.
You have a question or?